Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm here to review two comedies. And I'm going to do this in the spirit of which these comedies are being made, which is they're dead on screen. They're dead on screen. Yes, I feel this. And I'm just going to read a few of the comedies you and I have suffered through this terrible year. Little Fockers, do we remember beginning the year with that? The Dilemma, Adam Sandler's Just Go With It, No Strings Attached, Hall Pass, Take Me Home Tonight, From Prada to Nada, and Big Mamas, Like Father, Like Son. Let's Have a Burial, Scumbucket, Take Them All and Take Them Away. But I've got sadder news. There's two new comedies out now, two new ones that also deserve a Viking burial. I'm sorry. I'm going to start with Arthur. Arthur, yes, I'm hearing it, and yet I thought maybe this would be okay. Russell Brand is in it, who can be funny, and Helen Mirren is in it, who could win Oscars. And yet, does anybody remember the first Arthur with Dudley Moore and John Gielgud as his butler? Yeah, of course you do. That was a great movie. It was made in 1981. It was really funny. It's about a playboy Manhattanite drunk. Now, Russell Brand's own life, because here's a guy who himself is a recovering alcoholic, recovering sex addict, you know, and now, of course, just the husband of Katy Perry, so I suppose everything is great for him. But this movie dies from the very first scene. It's timid. I don't care about him. Instead, because this is the new world, we see Russell Brand have to go to an AA meeting, something Dudley Moore would never have done. So now we bring in cautionary fables. Helen Mirren is forced to be sentimental, and instead of his butler, who trashes him all the time, she gets to be sentimental, and his nanny, I'm sorry, dead. Put the nail in, scumbucket, sorry. Then, worse than anything, Your Highness, who loves Danny McBride more than I do? I watch on HBO him as Kenny Powers, the pitcher.
Kenny Powers!
Yeah, of course, he's great. Eastbound and Down, Foot Fist Way. This is a great guy, and he co-wrote this script. And he says it's because he loved movies like Crawl, who didn't, Beastmaster. And so he's going to be in a movie as a knight, as a prince, and his brother, Fabius, because he's not Fabius, played by James Franco. And the warrior, the female warrior he meets, is played by Natalie Portman.
Black Swan!
Yes! And the princess that gets kidnapped that James Franco loves, played by Zooey Deschanel.
Whoa.
Great cast! They all look ready to party. This dies because every single time there's a joke, somebody says, fuck you. Somebody says, shit. Somebody says,
penis!
Any kind of, penis. All of those words are said, and they're not funny. It dies. It sounds like a good idea, but it's an idea that dies on the screen. Even, as you say down there, penis. We have a Minotaur's penis. It's a hard-on. And then it's used as a totem to wear around your neck. Yes, I'm hearing taps playing because these movies suck. They are beyond the scumbucket. And what are we going to have next, people? What are we going to get? Big Mama's House 4? If we do, we've only ourselves to blame. We go to these movies. I'm here to tell you, never go. Bury them. Let them go. Let these people try again because I am fed up. And you know what? I'm not laughing. And I'm Peter Travers.